The detail on the katana is so nice. And hi, Billy Boy. And the new survivor is, where is he? Oh, here. I don't recognize her. She's so bland. Can I say that? She's really bland. Oh, and she has a pig nose. Okay.
She, no, I think she looks nice.
I think she resembles a Fang in some ways, but
her nose is weird.
Really?
Yeah. But anyway, I like her.
Yeah, but look at her face.
I think she has one of the best animations.
Let's see. Here is Fang, and then we have. She's taller than Fang.
She has more facial detail.
Yeah, I think it's more a lolicon. She does have the ghetto pants, that the pants are hanging low, which you see in a lot of in Afro-American culture, with those rappers or such. She has her pants like that.
Afro culture, man, that's hood culture.
Yeah, I don't know how, I call it Afro-American, but I don't know the correct
hood term. Just hood culture.
Yeah, so let's look at her perks.
Yep.
But I think she's one of those Bancho.
She has a top. She has a top that doesn't change color. Oh, it changes the name.
Yeah. I think she's part of the Bancho culture. Bancho, I think. She's supposed to be Bancho, if I'm correct. But
she's in a motorcycle group.
Yeah, that's Bancho, I think. Anyway, I think someone will correct me in the comment section. Anyway, she has a really weird nose. That's the only thing that I'm gonna say. Okay, let's go to the perks. I will read them like always, because I heard from people that they like it how I read stuff with the voice. So here I go. Lucky break. You've had your share of scrapes and bruises, but luck always on your side. Lucky Break activates anytime you are injured. You won't leave a trail of blood for a total of 120 seconds. Lucky Break is permanently deactivated for the remainder of the trial once the total duration has elapsed. That's not enough to beat me, not even close. Yui Kimaru, Kimura. What do you guys think of this perk?
Okay, I think it is essentially a perk to counter the Oni.
Aha.
Because since the Oni needs to collect blood, if you put Lucky Break, you don't leave trails of blood, so it can in part counter the power of the Oni.
This is a problem with this, because I think there might be a problem with a broken.
Oh.
They made this this perk to counter Oni, right?
Yeah.
And the whole purpose for it is so that you don't leave blood trails, so that he can't get the power.
Yeah.
What if you're playing with no Mither?
Yeah, there's also a thing.
Do you leave blood?
No, no Mither completely counters the Oni.
But no Mither gives blood to the Oni.
No, you don't. No blood at all. You are wounded, but you don't leave blood, I think.
It gives him points.
Oh, that will we then we will test it out during the gameplay test.
That's a test. But I will say I love this perk.
You
I
do.
love it so much.
Yeah.
Because this is one of those perks that you're gonna use troll people with. And say you have the lucky break,
Yeah.
and then you have the hemorrhaging, the med
Yeah.
kit.
Yeah.
You could go around, get hit, and then fly off like a little NASCAR, and then they can't see your trails.
That's true, but I personally I think this perk is very situational. It is not
Yeah, the problem also is in the last sentence because this perk is a one-time use.
Yeah,
So,
that's the dumb part.
in my opinion, it is essentially a perk good for countering killers that rely on blood to follow you. For example, you can use it for countering the spirit with the Father Glasses, for example.
Yeah.
Or you can use it in combo with Iron Will so that you don't emit sound and don't leave trails of blood. So
Yeah.
can be useful in stealth build for survivors. But anyway, I think it is quite limited by the one-time use. So
I find it a niche perk. It has,
yeah,
it's
yeah.
I think it is more a meme perk than anything else.
I'm
That's just me.
all about the meme.
Yeah, you are a living meme.
I've been ranking up in Survivor memeing.
Yeah, you are a living
That's
meme, man.
all I've been doing in Survivor when I've been playing as Survivor. So seeing this perk is just I'm gonna be using it because all I gotta do is it's a perk that you're gonna be using when you wanna take the killer's time. So if you're good at taking the killer's time and wasting it, that's 2 minutes gone from the killer that you can literally use for when you want to hit. Gonna get hit, jump through the window, get hit, take the hit, jump through the window, and then go anywhere you want because you're leaving the trails.
Yeah, but what if you are a killer that doesn't follow blood trails at all?
How would they find you?
I listen. I
You
listen my
want.
ass and I use my ears and I look at the scratch marks.
Oh no, you still get scratch marks. So yeah, no, this is trash.
See? That's what I mean. Okay.
Trash.
Okay, up.
Trash. I'd just rather stay with no mither. Get out of here.
Yeah. Don't you?
I'll stay with no mither. I thought that took away scratch
No,
marks.
only blood. And no killer follows blood. I think.
This is so stupid. Well, there is the
Oh,
Wraith.
yeah, right. And only, but only. But that is different type of blood. So I don't know how that works. So
We
yeah.
got whoa, clouds of
We will test it
blood.
out. We will test it out. One of you guys will go No Mitre, and the other one will go Lucky Break, and we will see which one of the perks is better.
Yep.
That's how we do it, people. We are hardcore. We are hardcore gamers. Okay.
Scientist, gamer scientist.
Scientists, yeah. We are better than game theory. Game theory can kiss our balls. And compared to. And game theory only has two balls, and we got six. And they are big. We can barely walk. Okay. Next perk. Any means necessary. You stand up for yourself, using whatever's on hand to gain an advantage. Press and hold the active ability button for 3 seconds while standing beside a drop pallet to reset it to its upright position. Any means necessary has a cooldown of 160 seconds. I'll hit you with everything I got, and then I'll do it again. Yui Kimura. So what do you guys think?
It is just a meme perk because it can be fully countered by simply breaking the pallets.
Yeah.
So even if you are facing a survive with friend group which could abuse the perk, you can just simply break all pallets. So
yeah,
it is quite situational perk in my opinion.
Yep. Do you have to say Dr. Meme or the King of Memes or the Living Incarnate of Memes?
I can tell you right now, if I can get a group of two or three people to just go and get this perk, yeah. I need to try this out. We need to go and try this out. And because she looks like she has a whole arsenal of memes at her disposal.
Yeah.
I mean, she looks like she's a meme helper.
I think we could do that once if I think that there are people that want to see it if we play Survivor, and then we're gonna go all three of us will go Yui Kimura or something, and we're gonna with this perk and such. We can do this for once. If people say that they want to see this, then we do this. I'm not too stupid to do it, so why not? I'm not gonna do it alone, but if they say yeah, we want to see Folk and Savage and KMK to use that perk, then okay, we do it. Then we do it, right, Falcon?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Tell me when.
Yeah, we we can do it when she comes out.
Yeah.
Simple as that.
Oh, but I need a buyer.
Yeah, me too. Falcon also has to buy her, so we all three of us has to buy her. It's not difficult. Or the women are being bought a lot these days for various services. So, and she will be bought for the meme service. If you dig it.
She and really is, because I'm gonna be using them dumb perks.
Yeah. Anyway. So yeah, Savage is going to rename himself to the Meme Man Savage instead of Macho Man. Instead of
just Savage Memes.
Yeah, Savage Meme Man or something like Macho Man Randy Savage or something. Anyway, let's go. Yeah. So let's go to the next one. Breakout. Okay. You kick into high gear when someone's in trouble, inspiring them to overcome any obstacle. When within 6 meters of a carried survivor, you gain the haste status effect. Moving at 5% increased speed, the carried survivor's vehicle speed is increased by 20%. Come, we are going to rip our way out of this. Yui Kimura.
Wow, I think that this can be abused by Survive with Friends group.
This is freaking a meme build!
Dude.
This makes body blocking a lot more viable, in my opinion. Yeah. And the wiggle speed increase is crazy.
That's not even the strongest form of the move. Let me see.
This is not even my final form. Freezer, freezer, freezer.
Oh my. Don't get me started. I love that.
Yeah, me too. Hold but
on. Just imagine you are carrying a survivor, then the other two or three come to body block you with this perk.
Oh my god.
It is essentially a free escape for the survivor you are carrying.
Yep. I think that's the only good perk that she actually has that is valuable.
This perk is so broken.
Yeah.
Yeah. potentially it could be broken.
Yeah.
Imagine especially, having
okay. especially in the end of coordinated groups.
Yeah, because nowadays it is you don't see it so often anymore that they start the body block, but this will promote body blocking again. This perk alone.
I have my perks already ready for her.
Yeah. She did.
These are so stupid.
I think the only builds that will counter this are the sleepover in hell builds. Those are the only builds that will be able to counter this. Sleepover in hell builds from killers. Also known as the basement builds.
I think about Mad Grit, for example.
Yeah.
Or Iron Grasp.
Yep.
Why not?
Or True Grit of the Legion. The one that when you miss your swing, then the wiggle meter will stop. We have to watch out with this perk. So yeah, this is really a perk that can do a lot. I mean, you only have to be 6 meters within the range of the killer to do it.
Yeah.
so you,
can run faster than the killer.
Yeah, and you just have to hide somewhere in a corner or something. So long that you're just within 6 meters, it is okay. That's all. You just have to be within 6 meters. Crazy. So you can basically hide behind a rock or in a corner, or you can be a fucking cloud dead.
Okay, so at the highest form it's and your speed is increased by 7%. Highest. So it stays 6 meters when you're carried, 7% increase in speed, and the wiggle speed is increased by 20%. Yep. So if you have this with boil over,
oh my god,
that's a 95% increase in wiggling off of the killer.
Slug builds are going to be rampant.
Now if I need to see how real this is. Because if another survivor is in this, and now another survivor has breakout, does it?
I don't know.
So, yeah, I understand what he wants to say. We don't know if this perk stacks.
Yeah.
That is a problem. If this perk stacks. We have a problem.
Yeah, that means that it is slugging season.
I'm telling you, I'm loving this woman. Because she's so stupid. She has so many troll abilities.
Dude, imagine if we still had all the size of strike. You know, the size of strike Falcon? Oh my god, that perk would have been broken with it.
Yeah.
Alright, let's go.
We will see.
That's about it for the survivor, right?
Yeah, I go back to Donnie. This perk is disgusting. I'm getting sick of
it. So, what do you think? Out of the three, what do you like?
Well, breakout is broken. That's for 100% for sure.
Hey, we can't say 100% because you haven't tried it yet.
That's true.
What about any means?
Well, like I said, the rest is just means. So, the pellet one, that could be funny, but it is easily countered. So, let's go to the Oni now, because it is now the time for the Oni to shine. First, we're going to look at his power and his attributes, because he is, of course, different than the survivors. He has 4.6 meters per second movement speed. It's basic.
Which is good.
He has basic terra radius of 32 meters. And he's tall. I would think he's bigger, but for here it is tall. So, his power is Yamaoka's Red, the desire to destroy weaker bloodlines, shaped into a literal force. Yamaoka's Red absorb blood orbs left by your injured foes. Press and hold the power button to absorb blood orbs in the environment and fill your power gauge. When your power gauge is full, press and hold the active ability button to initiate Blood Fury. Blood Fury. While Blood Fury is active, the Oni becomes lethal and gain access to additional abilities, Demon Dash and Demon Strike. Special ability, Demon Dash. Press and hold the power button while Blood Fury is active to perform a Demon Dash. This ability allows the Oni to cover large distances rapidly. Special ability number, special attack, Demon Strike. Press and hold the attack button while Blood Fury is active to perform a Demon Strike in the direction you are facing. Demon Strike has an extended launch range and successful hits immediately puts a healthy survivors into the dying state. That's the power of the Oni. What do you guys think of this power?
I think it is well balanced, because you have to earn your power, but then you have one shot ability, you have crazy map control, and all in all it is a good tracking ability, because you can see blood orbs even around the walls. So overall I think it is a well balanced power.
Nice.
Same thing here. There's nothing on that, because
yep,
it's pretty good. I'm gonna say it's pretty good. I guess the powers by hurting people.
Yep.
He doesn't get anything extra if he doesn't do work. So if you're bad at chasing, it'll get good.
Yeah, he rewards you for doing the basic stuff. Find, chase, and hit. And after that, once you get your power, you have to do with it what you can. It's a really good ability. It is standard gameplay. Standard gameplay, and that's all I can say. It only changes once you get this ability. So, all in all, balanced power. So, let's go to the perks. And the perks are... Dun 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 dun. Sunshin Tactics. Unlocks potential in one's aura reading ability. You are mentally alert and aware of key points on the battlefield. The auras of all pallets and fault locations are revealed to you within 24 meter range. When a survivor is damaged, this perk becomes inactive for 40 seconds. Within your enemy strength is weakness. Renjiro's Doctrine 12.5. Okay.
This is essentially windows of opportunity for the killer.
Yep.
I think it's a baby killer. It's like a perk for like a
perk for new killers.
Pick the perk and learn the windows.
Yeah.
It's to help you learn loot.
Yeah. It's to help you become more aware of your environment.
Like, there's this window on this side. Now this only person's gonna only have one window that's right. So if I already start going to the right, let me go there. That's how you get to.
Yep.
But then it goes away as soon as you get hurt.
Yeah. Yeah, it is. So
it kind of like gets to learning the game. So I would say it's good perk to help you learn.
Yeah, good perk for newbies.
Yeah, for beginners too. Yeah.
That's the only thing. It just hurts them that the perk will be gone for 40 seconds after they hit someone. So in that time you have to memorize everything.
Yeah, as long as you have a good map knowledge, I think you can avoid this perk without problems.
Yep. So we go to the next perk. Blood Echo. The agony of one is inflicted on others. When hooking a survivor, all other injured survivors suffer from the hemorrhage status effect until healed and the exhaustion status effect for 45 seconds. Attack an enemy with precision and their allies will feel it. Renjiro's Doctrine 6.3. I don't know how to say the last part, but I will just say 6.3. Okay, so what do you guys think about this perk?
Maybe the best perk out of the three.
Maybe, yeah. The thing is, the other survivors have to be injured for it to work.
Yeah, that is the only downside, in my opinion, because if it was applied to all survivors, it would be very, very good. But anyway, there are killers which can benefit from this perk heavily. I'm thinking about the plague, for example. Imagine if all survivors don't cleanse, essentially with this perk you can say goodbye to all exhaustion perk.
True.
Yeah, because anyway you hook someone, since the other ones are already infected, if they decide to not cleanse, then you can say goodbye to the dard, balanced landing, light, and sprint bars, of course.
That's true.
But so this perk can find a good synergy in anti-healing builds, in my opinion.
Yeah, totally.
Yeah, the more survivors you keep injured, the most use you can have from Blood Echo.
Yeah, that's totally true. Do you think of it, Savage?
I have nothing to go against it, other than it only works survivors that hurt.
Yeah. So that's the only thing, but that gives us good synergy with the plague, I think.
It's good. I think it's good for, not for Oni, but it is good if you are playing the slugging way.
Yeah.
Because if you're gonna be playing as Oni, there's gonna be a lot of money. You're gonna have people down on the floor, and people just going around trying to lift people up.
Yeah.
So good, because then their exhaustion perks, there's gonna be no dead hard.
Yep.
So that's also good.
Yeah. It counts as some of the most used exhaustion perks, so, but you still have to use them.
Yeah, most of the annoying exhaustion perks.
Yeah.
I can't wait to try this perk on my plague, because in combo with Thanatophobia, essentially I can really punish these stupid survivors which don't cleanse when I play the plane.
It also works on Legion, if I'm correct. Yeah.
So you don't want to cleanse, then you get this this penalty.
Yeah, say goodbye to your sprint burst and to your dead heart.
Yeah, at least.
It's fair. It's totally fair. So we go to the next perk. The next perk is called Nemesis. You seek retribution on those who have wronged you. A survivor who blinds or stuns you using a pellet or locker becomes your obsession. Any time a new survivor becomes the obsession, they are affected by the oblivious status effect for 40 seconds. And their aura is shown to you for 4 seconds. The killer can only be obsessed with one survivor at a time. Only a fool would spit in a demon's face and declare victory. Renjiro's Doctrine 4.9.
This perk, I really like.
You really like it?
I really like this perk because it's something that you can use with other killers.
To be honest, I like this perk also. This perk is overpowered with Rancor.
What about Spirit Fury?
The dream is mooring all four survivors with Nemesis and Rancor combo.
Spirit Fury is when the pellet breaks also. So yeah, it also works with Spirit Fury.
Because the pallet will still drop you, but it will, you'll get something for the Nemesis.
Yeah. Imagine if you have Spirit Fury and you and Rancor, and then you chase Shitty Cloud Dead, and she drops the pellet, and she becomes obsession. She hasn't been hit once, and you can down her instantly and more her. Man.
Anybody that drops a pallet on you, you'll be able to see where they're going for the next 4 seconds. That's hard.
Yeah. The thought of it already gives me a boner.
And the worst part about it is, this doesn't have a cooldown.
True. It has no cooldown at all. So...
It is basically, you have an unlimited use of this perk.
Yeah, because you can keep switching the obsession.
Yeah. you can be continuously switching obsession. So
that's so sexy.
I think that it is also good to counter the deep wound, in particular for the when a survivor gained the borrowed time. If they stun you, they will go down. And I can already hear Legion laughing in the darkness.
You guys won't laugh at me now for being so mean to me. That is from Semination, Legion. I'm gonna make my own group and we call ourselves Legion. You are already the Legion. Oh, yes, right. This is such a perk. This, if they add more good obsession perks, like Rancor such, but that work during the game, this is going to be a nasty perk and it's going to be the cornerstone of a lot of builds. I can already see the complaints about this perk coming. It's like this perk is made to go hand to hand with Rancor. It's not a coincidence. A coincidence?
That's what I'm saying. That's what, a lot of these people's perks.
Yeah.
Characters, they're like combo perk.
Yep.
These perks are able to combo with other perks, and I like that they've been taking certain abilities from other perks and combining them.
Yeah.
Leave no pools of blood.
Yeah.
For this girl.
Yeah.
Okay, so you want to go to...
Let's go to the fun part of the entire video. And that is something that Vulcan loves a lot. Perk builds. So let's go to the perk build selection and then the gameplay.